Good afternoon, my friends. Today, once again, the Agency for Investment in Development has made a thorough research on a case of science that can be applied to economics and to the global process of repairing the use of capital for a transformation to a sustainable world and a sustainable development in the long term. Let's start by science, please, first. Now, 100 years ago, the chestnut tree from Asia came to America in seeds, small bags of seeds in a ship. They were planted in the woods because they used to grow faster and they could deliver better wood at a lower cost. But the point is that they came with a fungus over the tree. It means the seed that they planted in the woods of America, the trees grow, these trees had a fungus over their trees, and this fungus then went to the American chestnut, the beloved American chestnut. What happened then later? In no more than 10 years, 100,000 or more trees of chestnut were killed, destroyed. Not their roots, but destroyed. Now, how can we understand this on economics? Now, 40, 50 years ago, China opened their economy to the world for investment, for trade, for technological transfer. What happened from that moment until now? The world trade order has changed so much that now we got something important. It means that prices on all these years in several key products and key markets have been below the range that makes those markets sustainable. Moreover, those prices have destroyed value and potential growth, moreover, in emerging markets. Second, logistics. Through all this time, especially in the last years, China have been buying mining, oil, gas worldwide, taking a good share of the global market in order to manage prices in the long term. What is going to deliver this from the next 10 to 20 years or 50 years in front? Disturbances in the process of capital building in the emerging markets. It means that the process of opening to the world trade, to the world investment, to the world technology, under a clear geopolitical view of using the system against the system, of course, has worked and is part now the process of a third point, the accumulation of capital and liquid capital in China. Moreover, the same is happening with Russia. So, what we've got here? We are in a clear process of repairing the globe, repairing their financials, and making their financials to work for the poor over a model that make possible a sustainable growth for the globe, for the total planet. But whenever we deliver these disturbances in a normal trade, in normal finance, in normal prices, of course, we're going to have a lot of halts and hampers in the process to deliver the repairing tools. How can we avoid this problem now? Let's go back. First of all, whenever we understand the Asian chestnut tree and the fungus, we will see also the solution. American scientists have delivered the solution and now are waiting to have the license to plant the new trees, the new American trees, so they can restore the classical American chestnut. This is going to be work by genetics, and this is going to be work by altering and putting a small piece of genes from mice into the tree. So it's going to not absorb the fungus that the Chinese and the Asian chestnut tree has brought to America. But the point is this: if we want to have a solution of this, we first must understand the collective memory of a whole civilization. It means, if we go backwards, we will see that in China, there are a lot of bills to be paid by the world because they have been used for drugs, they have been used for exploitation, they have been used for slavery and other means of using this whole country, this whole continent at the same time. So the solution for this is, first of all, understanding the collective memory they have and the bill they are trying to collect of the more than 1,000 years that they have been used worldwide. So this process is quite difficult because at this moment the interdependence of China with the world is so big, and the same thing is happening right now with Russia and with Europe, that the values with which hundreds of thousands of American soldiers dead in the Second World War are now missing, are now out of the platform to decide and to deal for the repairing process of the globe. That's something that must be taken back to the table of negotiations. And if we need to restore the system in order to be stable, the first thing is to put the bills clear with China and put the bills clear with Russia and other key countries that are still on their collective memory asking those bills, historical bills, to be paid. So they are delivering geopolitical issues, geopolitical strategies, those bills to be paid. One way to solve this solution is, first of all, recognizing those bills openly, without letting one single point of the history to be recognized. And the second thing, as American scientists did, is to put a new gene on the chestnut tree of the world. It means values, ethical values, clear ethical values that have made hundreds of thousands of American soldiers to have lost their lives in the battlefields of the Second World War in a strange country, just to give to the world a new meaning of democracy, values, freedom. That afterwards, through the Cold War, we have lost a lot of them because the same process of the Cold War made a lot difficult to deliver those values. So the key gene to restore the chestnut tree of the world is values, and make people work around them and be part of the agenda, and not just the revenge of the past bills that every country, every people have, every person have. And if it's going to be always over the table, of course, there won't be a possibility of repairing the system. Moreover, now the capital, the concentration of capital, if we want to understand that, is in the hands of the state capital of China and Russia. So, how can we make these two big countries, which in their collective memory, they want to take back a big bill of history, to cooperate, to be part of the repairing process of the worldwide economy, but not to think that the only winners are going to be them. The winners must be every single person of the world. That's why here, in the Investment Agency for Development, we are taking this as a really serious responsibility toward each person that is working in each place of the world for the long term, in order to deliver them sustainability, growth, and moreover, values that can give them a cushion, a toolkit, in order to be part of a process of repairing and cooperate and be part of the winners of the whole repairing process. From here, I am greeting you, hoping that this can be helpful for understanding how the world cannot go so far with the game, with the play game we have set. Moreover, when there are institutions that are making great efforts to make the things work, but the whole world is against them. Thanks, have a nice day. It was a pleasure to be with you. Best regards, Investment Agency for Development.